classic case of greenhouse effect. So if somebody asks you, explain greenhouse effect, this is the simplistic way, most simple way of explaining it. Yeah, so you could talk about it. So as you know, explanation of effects of global warming, both by more economically developed countries versus less economically developed countries. So this is the impact, as you know. More temperate climates leads to major wheat production. You know, you see that in some parts of the US. Drier conditions reduce the grain harvest. These two conditions are seen in this part of the US. I live here in this part, which is New York, and maybe I do some agriculture. So anyway, so you know, reduced rainfall in rainforest due to deforestation. This is where Amazon traverses to five countries. Brazil is, of course, it's a lung for oxygen, it's a huge sink. You know, and we are losing the Amazon forest area quite drastically by then. Floods in Florida and Egypt, we could see that as a direct impact. Floods in Bangladesh, you know, which is going to impact us as well, impact you. I mean, I will be gone, but it's going to impact you also by a number of reasons. Drier conditions reducing grain harvest in this part of the world. So this is Siberia. Not a lot of problems here. Here, yes, absolutely. But forest productivity, yes, but vegetation, the agricultural productivity, of course, in grain harvest is going to be lost here. Higher rainfall gives higher rice yields in this part of the world. As you know, rice is produced largely in India, Sri Lanka, China, and East Asia, including parts of Bangladesh. More temperate climates makes land productive for wheat and corn in this area. So basically, you're looking at a shift in agricultural patterns. You know, the crops that you produce are going to change based on the availability of rainfall, based on the climatic factors, based on the heat that gets produced. And these are the problems. I mean, of course, you know, this is available from the internet. I need to do it myself. If you just looked at the internet, if you had a look at it, you know the impacts that they have. As you know, rising sea level, every book will talk about this, increased temperatures, absolutely. Habitat damage in species that are being affected, this is something that I'm drawn and interested in. I've been working on a few species. Majorly, tree species that are present in Western Dutch. We have a book chapter that sits out of the writing limit. Changes in water supply, this is having a huge impact because, well, all these would lead to multiple effects. You know, people having to move from one area to the other, loss of productivity, you know, economics, loss of money to other countries, a lot of geographical areas in a few countries, you know, countries such as, for example, Bangladesh, Tuvalu, in the Pacific. it's going to impact India as well because India has a coast of about 4,000 kilometers, one of the longest in the world, so that's going to impact us in many ways. Productivity, forest productivity is going to decline, change, number of areas. So basically, this is a classical picture that I showed. So this is Alaska in 1914. You know, this is basically covered with ice. Exact picture in 2004, you know, it's all about melted and then you see it relating. This was by, you know, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Association in the US. This is they do a lot of work in Alaska. This is going to be bad. So basically, Arizona River, you see June 2002 how it was, and December 2003 how it is now, how it was. And it's a huge decrease. And I think, I don't know, I don't have data after 2003, unfortunately, but I'm sure. Well, if we dig or if we go to NOAA, they will provide more details. At this point, let me stop and then give you an exercise for you to work on. Let's come back to the electromagnetic spectrum. At this point, it gets a little deeper. So this is for level 2 and level 3. Level 2 should be for 3 days or something like that. Level 3 would be for a week. We'll talk about it. But I will touch upon some bits and pieces before I present to you, but open the class, open the presentations. But we'll just do one more assessment. I'll tell you what the assessment is, because this is important. I included this assessment. I will tell you where the question is. Okay, question number 8. Okay, what will you do after your respective MS and PhD programs? Be honest. Okay, this is quite important because the reason why I included this slide was I thought perhaps if you're interested in a field of research that I have some contact with, I can put you on. That is the only thing. And my institute also wanted me to include this slide, so I get an understanding of what. Be honest with me, okay? If you say I want to become a politician, it's okay. It doesn't matter. No, just be honest with yourself. Be honest with me. Be honest with yourself, because that's what it is. Because at the end of the day, don't cheat yourself. You're here. You're paying money. You're spending 2 years of your money. Be honest. Who cares? No. Yeah. So 5 minutes, exactly 5 minutes. Yeah. You don't have to write it down. Just discuss among yourself and we'll deliberate. Okay? We'll talk with you. We'll just discuss. Completely be honest. And the reason, as I said, if there's a way I can help in putting you into pertinent people elsewhere, I'm happy. Okay? Let's do it. Yeah, 5 minutes starting now, please. Yes.
You don't know what you're doing. What do you want?